So my name is Morten Madsen. I'm an associate professor at the University of Southern Denmark. My research area is in organic photovoltaics, where we do different things on both optimizing efficiency, stability, and also now upscaling of these devices. So I think one of the reasons that the field of organic and hybrid photovoltaics has been increasing in interest over the past years is due to the fast progress they have made, especially in the efficiency of the devices. So organic devices has increased up to 13.2% now. Beginning of 2000, they were at a few percent. Pale skies have done it even faster. They are above 20% now, and that's within 3 to 4 years. And of course, given the nice features that these devices has, this is especially mechanical flexibility. You can make devices semi-transparent. You can make them extremely bendable. It opens up for some other integration aspects. So if you can make devices that are efficient and keep these appealing properties, I think it could be interesting for the community of photovoltaics in general. So if one compares the drawbacks of the technology of organic and hybrids compared to, for example, silicon technology, which is the main player on the market today, definitely it's still both efficiency and stability. You talk about the triangle of OPV and perovskite technology that needs to be fulfilled: efficiency, stability, and price. And I think for efficiency, we have seen many good progresses over the last years. We have also shown that for upscaling, you can do roll-to-roll production, so you can actually print the devices rather cheap. But for stability, we still see that the devices, they simply die out faster than silicon. And I think if it should be a viable technology on the market, we really need to improve the performance over time. So a lot of the researchers now are focused on how do we improve the lifetime, the stability of these organic and hybrid devices. And there's progress, but there's still work to be done. And I think this is the drawback that will catch researchers' attention over the next years. I think for the market or commercialization of the organic and hybrid technologies, I think especially in the beginning, when they will start to be commercialized, it will be on some niche products that only organic and hybrid devices can deliver. Their performances will not initially be as high as for silicon, maybe also for a longer period. But since you can make them mechanically flexible, you can make them semi-transparent, I think you will see them on niche products where they can be integrated in a way that inorganic cannot. And therefore, it won't be a direct competitive technology compared to silicon, because it would fill up the market in other areas, I think. Over time, of course, if you improve efficiency, stability more, maybe there's a chance that it will also go in on areas where silicon is now, so mainly large area PV plants. But this time has to tell.